levels are 5% higher than their historic average for this time of year. In fact, Shasta Lake is almost completely full.
Nestled in Northern California lies the serene Shasta Lake. But recently, this tranquility was shattered. Headlines erupted. The world took notice. The brightest minds searching for answers. A once beloved destination, now clouded with questions and fears. A community on edge, waiting for answers. Theories abound, but which holds the key? Stay with us and make sure to hit the subscribe button now as we dive deep into this unfolding mystery. As the saying goes, never say never when it comes to Lake Shasta. This dry lake is currently experiencing extraordinary inundation. However, while the Lake Shasta surge, it is welcome news to California residents who perceive it as a respite from the California sun. Scientists are concerned about the consequences of this. Can Lake Shasta keep its current condition, or is this the resurgence before the storm? Summer will never be the same for inhabitants of California as a result of the residents of California can now enjoy all of the benefits of having a full lake thanks to the restoration of the once dry Shasta Lake. Even though this appears to be excellent news, scientists are still trying to understand what the lake's future holds. To give you some context, let us introduce you to Lake Shasta. Shasta Lake has been around for a while, having been formed in 1948. 12 years after the Shasta Dam's construction, Shasta Dam was hailed as an engineering marvel for its day. This stern stood 602 feet tall. The Shasta Dam was built between 1935 and 1945. Lake Shasta is unquestionably the most prominent artificial lake in California. It has a storage capacity of 4,552,000 acre feet, which is massive, for lack of a better description. This connection has an elevation of 1,067 feet and a surface area of 30,000 acres. Shasta Lake has a maximum depth of 517 feet and a maximum length of 35 miles due to its total capacity. Embodying the essence of aquatic escapades, water sports like boating capture the heart's exhilaration. Activities such as skiing, fishing, and camping are in full swing. With panoramic views stretching across the horizon, it's evident why the region lures both adrenaline junkies and those seeking tranquil moments. One look at Lake Shasta's vast 587-kilometer coastline is all it takes to understand its allure. The surrounding evergreens and the adjacent Manzanita Lake enhance its untouched beauty. Four distinct arms, each sculpted by a unique river, stretch out from the lake. Explorers navigating its waters can trace these arms to the Sacramento Pit and McLeod Rivers. Diving deeper, remnants of the submerged town of Kenneth and the Wintoon village lie hidden. Occasionally, as the waters retreat, glimpses of the decommissioned tunnels of the Northern Pacific Transportation Company emerge. Shasta Lake has always buzzed with aquatic activities since its inception. Events like the boardstock competition made waves here. The maiden boardstock event graced these waters from 1996 to 1999, after which it shifted to Clear Lake, California. Fishermen are in for a treat, with the lake brimming with species like sturgeon and catfish. Meanwhile, nature lovers can marvel at the majestic sight of bald eagles and ospreys soaring above. More than a picturesque man-made lake, Shasta Lake serves crucial roles in agriculture, hydroelectricity, and flood control. Yet its current splendor and enhanced features are largely attributed to the lake's unexpected rise in water levels amidst its blooming state. During a recent three-year stretch, Shasta Lake, a vital California reservoir, suffered a severe drought due to diminished snowpack and scarce rainfall. By September 2021, the lake was only 24% full, 175 feet below the dam's top. This dire situation affected not only Shasta Lake's recreational activities, but also numerous water agencies and companies in California, leading to drastic cuts in water supply allocations. The striking contrast of bright orange soil against the lake's blue waters and green tree line underscored the crisis. As the drought intensified, farmers received only 18% of their typical annual water quota, and energy production from the hydro dam drastically dropped. Yet by 2023, Shasta Lake remarkably rebounded, showcasing its resilience. Let us examine how this once dry lake regained its zeal for life. Discuss the Lake Shasta Renaissance. In the aftermath of a prolonged drought, 2023 saw a meteorological marvel in California: heavy rainfalls and significant winter snow. This deluge dramatically refilled Shasta Lake. Experts had anticipated a rain-rich year to rejuvenate Shasta's reservoirs, and weren't disappointed. By this year, Lake Shasta surged close to its total capacity. To truly comprehend this remarkable resurgence, let's dive into the figures. On May 9th, Shasta Lake surged by an impressive 150 feet, hitting the 1,063-foot mark. nearly reaching its maximum capacity of 1067 feet. Satellite images from NASA Earth Observatory spanning November 18, 2020 to May 29, 2023 capture this transformation, revealing that by May 9th, the lake was a mere 3 feet from overflowing. To put it in perspective, in 2023, the water level surged from 31% at the start to a staggering 98% by May's end. Ponder on this timeline for a moment. The lake began the year at a level of 918 feet. By January 16th, it rose to 928 feet. By May's end, it reached a lofty 1063 feet. This dramatic revival of Shasta Lake is nothing less than a testament to nature's wonder. Today's numbers unmistakably underscore the marvel of Lake Shasta's comeback. By July 9th, the levels had declined slightly to 1054 feet. Yet, nature's tenacity was evident, echoing the record height of 1064.5 feet set by the lake in 2019. The previously parched shores are now alive with water enthusiasts. It's a bounty for water companies. Drawn by the allure of California's golden sun, masses flock to Sacramento, fishing rods are thrown, boats cruise effortlessly, and the horizon is dotted with ecstatic visitors. The transformation also means booming business for lakeside accommodations like the Shasta Lake cabins. Memories of a near-shuttered past due to the preceding year's drought are slowly fading. Although skeptics had cast a long shadow of doubt over the lake's recovery, optimistic locals like Jones from Sugarloaf Cottages believed otherwise. He had always maintained that a robust winter would surge the water levels back, pointing to the distant trees as a marker. Now, as Lake Shasta brims once again, the entire state celebrates. California's water reserves are rejuvenated, and eager recreation enthusiasts can hardly contain their excitement. Tourists can look forward to expansive beaches, deeper waters, and enhanced boating experiences. Lake Shasta Cabins alone has already welcomed over 450 guests in April, with predictions soaring as high as 70,000 by year's end. Indeed, except for a minor hiccup at Trinity Lake, Lake Shasta's revival is a cause for universal celebration. Nestled in the heart of Trinity County, California, the waters of Trinity Lake are mysteriously receding. How is this happening, especially with neighboring Oroville brimming at 97% capacity by May 29th? And isn't rain and snow supposed to rejuvenate lakes like these? While Trinity Lake's story diverges from that of Shasta Lake, which dates back to 1948, its origin is no less fascinating. Emerging from the construction of the Trinity Dam in 1961 as an integral component of the Central Valley Project, Trinity Lake is primarily nurtured by the snowpack and rain from nearby mountains that feed into the Trinity River. If a trip to Trinity Lake is on your horizon, be prepared to be mesmerized by its tale and surroundings. However, an intriguing question lingers. Amid storied neighbors like the 98-year-old Shasta, 93-year-old Folsom, and the bustling Oroville, why isn't one of California's largest reservoirs overflowing? Let's unpack this mystery. Currently, Trinity stands at a modest 43, just a tad above its historical mean. One can't help but ponder the peculiarities of this reservoir. Delving deeper, one discovers that Trinity Lake has grappled with a devastating 3-year drought, among its worst ever. While the reservoir last witnessed its regular peak levels in 2019, it's lagging in its recovery compared to Shasta. This is due to its smaller drainage basin, and though the lake did witness significant rainfall, it hasn't rebounded as swiftly as its counterpart in Shasta. This might sound disheartening for those in Trinity County, but it's crucial to remember, hope still flickers. Trinity Lake's water levels prosper when Lake Shasta thrives. How does this work? When Lake Shasta is full, the Bureau of Reclamation retains more water within Trinity Dam instead of diverting it to the Sacramento River. Less diversion means Trinity Lake's levels remain more stable. In 2006, the lake peaked with an impressive 2,496,779 acre-feet, contrasting starkly with its 2015 low of 470,176 acre-feet. As of August 4th this year, it recorded 1,400,097 acre-feet, a noticeable improvement from the 2015 numbers. But before you write off Trinity Lake, consider its unique nature and potential. Interestingly, the area experienced fewer rainfalls this year than other parts of California. Adding to Trinity Lake's water level challenges is its reliance on snowpacks over direct rainfall. Water is more than necessary in California's sweltering landscapes. It's the lifeblood, particularly during the blistering summer months. Yet, after enduring a lengthy drought, California is now on the lookout for another looming danger, flash floods. Thanks to the recent spate of wetter weather, the Sierra Nevada mountains wear a denser snowmantle than usual. As climatic changes usher in powerful storms, the snow buildup on these mountains is exceptionally pronounced. Yet, when springtime emerges, and this snow begins its downhill journey, it's a mixed blessing. These melting snowpacks promise to generously recharge the reservoirs, contributing 30% to California's freshwater reserves. However, there's a flip side. The prolonged drought has rendered the soil too dry to absorb water quickly. Consequently, the influx from the Sierra Nevada could lead to swift, devastating torrents. Navigating between the benefit of reservoir refilling and the threat of sudden floods is a precarious balance that California now observes with keen anticipation. In a recent revelation by April-level officials, snow sensor readings have shown values higher than any observed since their installation in the mid-1980s. While these findings are alarming, California's safeguard against potential catastrophes lies in adept flood control practices. We can significantly reduce flood risks by giving rivers ample room to flow, perhaps by relocating levees and ensuring reservoirs maintain sufficient space for runoff. For instance, managing downstream reservoirs can help prevent potential flooding at places like Lake Shasta. However, while a full Lake Shasta might seem celebratory, experts have a word of caution. Full reservoirs don't guarantee sustained water supply. They can deplete just as rapidly as they fill. Don Bader, Northern California's manager for the Bureau of Reclamation, is optimistic about Lake Shasta remaining abundant throughout summer. He also anticipates that winter storms will replenish the lake fully, leading to potential water releases via the Shasta Dam spillway. But here's the kicker. Despite the reprieve wet weather brings from drought, we can't afford to be complacent. We're still navigating through precarious waters. We'd love to hear your insights on Lake Shasta's resurgence and its implications for the looming drought. We would love to listen to your feedback in the comments section. If you liked this video, please give us a like and subscribe and get the notifications button for our latest videos. Bye for now.